Hello and welcome to HMS Tech Talks. Every year, HMS carries out a market survey of the industrial network shares. And we have Anders Hansson, our CMO, here to talk about this year's study and what we've come up with. Welcome, Anders.
Thanks a lot. Nice to be here.
Looking at this year, if we start from a macro perspective, what is it that we measure and how do we go about it?
Yeah, first of all, this has really become a tradition now. I think it's the 11th year that we're doing it. We're getting some good data and can see trends. So what we measure is that we are presenting updated figures on industrial networks every year. And we're looking at market shares. We're looking at growth rates on an overall perspective for field buses, industrial Ethernet, and wireless technologies. And what we're doing is that we're looking at new installed nodes within factory automation. And the study actually presents HMS consolidated view, taking into account, first of all, our own sales statistics, insights from colleagues in the industry, and the overall market perception about industrial networks. So that's pretty much the scope of our study here.
Right. Why is HMS a good player to do this in the first place?
Yeah, I think HMS, for us, networks is core. We can say that we are simply in love with networks. It's been a story for 30 years now being on the market. We are known for having a great understanding of the technology and the market as well. I think that could be said by HMS. And then also I think that we are known for a neutral position. We are not really favoring any separate network from another. We've been listening to our customers, following the evolution of the market and creating solutions for the networks that people are asking for. So basically, with that said, I think we're in a pretty good position to have an opinion on the network market, I would say.
Right, so let's have a look at the study itself. So we'll show this famous pie chart here and have a dive in. What can we see from a general perspective?
Yeah, I mean, looking at this pie chart, it's actually a fantastic picture. It's almost like a painting. It's a snapshot of the industry as it has emerged over these years. And I mean, having been part of this study now for these 11 years, and it's been very interesting to see the evolution. In the early stage, it was the field buses pretty much only, and then the continuous growth of industrial Ethernet networks, and now the wireless technologies that have emerged as well. And I think also that this pie chart shows a very heterogeneous picture. Of course, you can develop solutions for one network, but in fact, for any company that is targeting the global market, it is actually required to be able to connect to several different industrial networks, because that leverages the competitive edge quite significantly.
So if we look at the overall picture between industrial Ethernet and fieldbus and wireless, what are the trends that we see here?
Yeah. So first of all, we can see that the entire pie is growing by 8% for 2022. And then on the other hand, we say that until 2025, we estimate roughly that the market will be growing by 5 to 7%. So we see a positive trend for this year. And then looking at the different parts of the pie, industrial Ethernet is growing by 1% market share here. And that means 10% growth in itself. For field buses, despite losing 1% in the share, it's interesting to see that it's actually coming back to 4% growth here. That could be a sign of companies in difficult times going for more existing, well-working technologies rather than moving to the newer, sometimes industrial Ethernet technologies.
Right,
so it's quite interesting because we have seen a decline for field buses over quite many years now. And coming back to growth again, I would say, for field buses this year.
Because we know that factory automation is kind of a conservative business.
Exactly. And then the wireless technologies here, we're of course waiting for the impact for 5G here. Mm-hmm. But in the meantime, we see stability. So it's growing in line with the overall market at 8%. So keeping 7% market share. And what is driving this? Well, we see cable replacement solutions feeding industrial network data over a wireless link. Also, the fact that customers would like to access machines wirelessly, And we also see mobile equipment emerging as something new in different manufacturing situations. So connectivity for mobile equipment,
like
also
AGVs
over,
and
yeah, like wireless that. Link. Mm-hmm. That's also driving wireless.
Right. So if we look at the individual networks, we see two winners, Profinet and Ethernet IP on top. What are the other trends that we see here?
Yeah, I would say the winner this year is actually EtherCAT. So EtherCAT is growing significantly. And the adoption rate is high, growing from, I think, 8% last year to 11% now, and closing in on the two ones, Profinet and Ethernet IP, that are battling up front at 70%. But the gap is closing in, so let's see what happens in the coming years. We also see an interesting fact about the Modbus technologies. I mean, we have the Modbus RTU fieldbus, and we have the Modbus TCP Ethernet version, and we see actually an increased usage of Modbus technologies in factories this year.
Which has been around for quite some time.
It's been around, and it's super good for retrofitting solutions to have that Modbus RTU enabled machine there, but then bring it up to whatever industrial network you want with a gateway. So it's quite interesting as well.
All right, so if we look at the general trends here, what are the big picture that we see going forward here?
Yeah, good question. So the key driver, as we see it, is that industrial connectivity and network communication is an absolute key to reach these objectives in manufacturing that has to do with productivity and sustainability, the overall key objectives.
Right, because these are big drivers that we see in the market.
And then there are other things that relate to this, but if I would pick one thing on general level, that would be this, the productivity and sustainability gains that we can get from industrial connectivity. The data and the insights as well, the ability to control equipment to a greater extent and to feed out data for better decision making. And then when it comes to technologies, as we have mentioned in previous years now, we have TSN, interesting of course, see what happens with this, OPC UA FLC, field level communication, also an interesting initiative when it comes to standardization. And we also see single pair Ethernet is also another initiative that is gaining some traction. So there are things ongoing also within this little bit conservative industry to move forward. But at the end of the day, these initiatives are meeting a very heterogeneous market. So the question is how this will feed into the overall market with all these networks that we just talked about.
Yeah, because this is applicable to most of the networks that we have on the chart.
Yeah, it will be. And then, but also say that we, looking at other trends, we should not forget the retrofitting aspect. I mean, new meets old here, and having the ability to feed in new technologies, but also have a nice connectivity to the existing equipment in factory, enabling customers to actually keep machinery and devices that are working. That is also a very good thing to think about for vendors out there who are aiming to, let's say, make the most of connectivity.
And, and that's one of the big uses for HMS products to retrofit.
So, you could say that the new meets old and hardware meets software.
Yeah. As HMS stands for.
Exactly.
All right. Thanks very much for talking to us, Anders.
Okay, very good.